Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to recreate the look of an old fine art intaglio print engraving from a photo. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to Blue Lightning TV, click that small subscribe button at the lower right corner to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. If I've helped you learn or improve in Photoshop, or inspired you to explore your creativity, please show your support by joining my community of patrons. I provided this paper texture for you to download. Its link is in my video's description below or project files. Open a photo that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. If you want to remove the background behind your subject, we'll take care of that in a minute. First, we'll place the photo onto the paper document I provided. To do this, make your Move tool active by pressing V on your keyboard and drag the photo onto the tab of the paper document. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag the photo down and release. To resize the photo, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift if you're using a version earlier than CC 2019 and drag it in or out. If you're using CC 2019 or later, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. To reposition it, go inside the Transform's bounding box and drag it. Then press Enter or Return or press the check mark at the top. Since I already sized and positioned my photo initially, I'll click the cancel icon. If you don't want to remove the background behind your subject, you can skip the next few steps. However, if you do want to remove the background, you'll need to make a selection around your subject. There are many ways to do this, and your choice should depend on the characteristics of your photo. In most cases, I generally use the quick selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, drag it over your subject to select it. To refine its edges, go to Select. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2015.5, click Refine Edge. If you're using a later version, click Select and Mask. However, if you prefer to use Refine Edge instead of Select and Mask, shift-click Select and Mask to open Refine Edge. I did in-depth tutorials on both of these filters, so if you'd like to watch them, I provided both of their links in my video's description below. Once you made and refined the selection around your subject, output it to a layer mask. Whether or not you removed the background behind your subject, we'll convert the image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right corner of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Solid Color. In the hexadecimal field, type in 4E3500. Change the blend mode to color. Make your subject active and go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Chalk and Charcoal. Make the Charcoal Area 4, the Chalk Area 20, and the Stroke Pressure 1. We want to remove the white strokes. To do this, change its blend mode to Multiply. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Double-click the copy's filter gallery to open it. Close the Sketch folder and open the Stylize folder. Click Glowing Edges. Make the Edge Width 1, the Edge Brightness 20, and the Smoothness 4. Click the Adjustment Layer icon again, and this time, click Invert. Notice our entire document inverted because adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel. Since we want just our subject to be inverted and not our entire document, we need to clip it or restrict it to affect just our subject. To do this, click the Clipping Mask icon or press Alt-Control-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. Another way is to go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. We'll brighten our subject a bit with another adjustment layer. Click Levels and clip it. Make the input shadows 82 and the input highlights 157. Lastly, we'll create a custom brush that will transform our image into the look of an Intaglio print. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill the empty layer with white, but first, check your foreground and background colors. If they are not black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since white is our background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Open your Pencil tool and Pencil Picker. Pick a soft, round brush. Make its size 1 pixel and its hardness and opacity both 100%. Draw diagonal, horizontal, and vertical lines approximately this length and this far apart from each other until it looks something like this. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag it over your pencil strokes. Go to Edit and Define Brush Preset. I'll name it Crosshatch, but you can name it anything you want. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Hide the top layer and make the bottom subject active. We'll make an inverted layer mask next to it by Alt-clicking or Option-clicking the layer mask icon. This hides or masks out the layer next to it. To reveal the subject, we'll brush in white over the layer mask using the brush strokes we just created. We want white to be our foreground color. If it isn't, press X on your keyboard. Open your brush tool, which gives us a softer stroke. Open your brush picker, and at the bottom of the panel, click the custom brush you just created. Then, press Enter or Return. Go to Window and Brush Settings, or you can press the F5 key at the top of your keyboard. Click Brush Tip Shape. Make the size 125 pixels and the spacing 50%. Click Shape Dynamics. Make the angle jitter 100%. Then close the panel. Brush over your entire subject. Now invert the colors of your brush by pressing X and selectively brush over your subject to gradually mask out areas that you previously brushed in. Continue to finesse your image until you're happy with it. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.